我们现在请法大众请合掌。We will be requesting the Dharma now. Please put your palms together. Gong qing da zhe san qing, wei zhi fa hui, ji yi xue zhong sheng. 请转妙法轮，教教我们如何了生脱死离苦得乐，修正无上。Will the Sanghas with great virtue out of compassion, for the sake of this assembly and all living beings, please turn the wonderful Dharma wheel to teach us how to leave suffering and attain bliss and mirth and death, and quickly realize non-birth.
南无色当托苏伽多耶阿拉诃帝三藐三菩提耶。南无色当托苏伽多耶阿拉诃帝三藐三菩提耶。南无色当托苏伽多耶阿拉诃帝三藐三菩提耶。南无药师海会佛菩萨。南无药师海会佛菩萨。南无药师海会佛菩萨。
Namo Sivas, Medicine Master Assembly of Buddhas and Bodhisattvas.
无上甚深微妙法，百千万劫难遭遇。我今见闻得受持，愿解如来忏法意。
The unsurpassed, profound, and wonderful Dharma is difficult to encounter in hundreds of millions of eons. I now see and hear it, receive and uphold it, and I vow to truly understand the Tathagata's repentance Dharma.
诸佛菩萨、师父上人、各位善知识，今天是太平洋时间公元2021年4月24日，我们在金山圣寺，今天呢还是继续要跟大家一起来研究药师宝忏的妙义。
Buddhas, Bodhisattvas, and all the wise knowing advisors, it is Pacific time, April 24th, 2021. We will continue studying the wonderful meanings of Medicine Master's repentance at the Gold Mountain Monastery.
我们今天呢，会继续研究的是《药师琉璃光如来本愿功德经》的一段经文。
We will continue studying the section of the sutra in the Sutra of the Merit and Virtue of the Past Vows of Medicine Master Vaiduyalai Tathagata.
首先呢，我先给大家知道哈，《药师经》有两个版本。第一个版本是现在我给大家看的版本，是大唐三藏法师玄奘奉诏译，就玄奘大师所翻译的。还有另外一本呢，今天如果会谈到那个部分呢，就会给大家看到另外一个版本。
First of all, I'd like to make you aware that we have two translation versions of the Medicine Master Sutra. The first version you see is what we have on the screen. It's translated by the Tripitaka Dharma Master Xuanzang of the Tang Dynasty. As for another version, when we read through the text, if we have a chance, we will show you.
我们一起来攻读经文。复次，曼殊师利，若有四众，必除毗卢尼， 乌波所迦，乌波斯迦，及于净信善男子、善女人等。
We'll read the text. Moreover, Manjushri, there may be those among the fourfold assembly of bhikshus, bhikshunis, upasakas, and upasikas, as well as other men and good women of pure faith.
释迦牟尼佛呢，又继续叫了一声曼殊师利，也就是文殊师利啊。他说：“若有四众必除，必除你乌波所迦、乌波斯迦，就是说，假如呢有佛陀的弟子啊，四众的弟子，比丘、比丘尼、优婆塞、优婆夷，啊，就是一般的四众弟子，或者是还不算是皈依受五戒的净信善男子、善女人，哈，这种善男子、善女人是对佛法有信心。”但是还不可以称为优婆塞、优婆夷，表示是他还没有，受五戒哈，也还没有，可能连皈依都还没有，可是已经开始相信佛法了，啊，对佛法也有清净的信心，只是时间还没到，他还没有皈依或者还没有受五戒，像这样子的善男子、善女人等等的。
Okay, so we will continue. Here Shakyamuni Buddha called out Manjushri Bodhisattva, if the fourfold assembly, which means bhikshus, bhikshunis, upasakas, and upasikas, these are the fourfold assembly, as well as pure men and pure women who have not taken refuge, but they have faith in the Buddha Dharma. So because they haven't taken refuge or have not taken the five precepts, they cannot be called upasaka or upasika. However, they already have faith, believe in the Buddha Dharma. So it's just not time yet. The time is not ripened for them to take the precepts. So these are good men and good women of pure faith.
有能受持八分斋戒，或经一年，或复三月，受持学处。
Who accept and uphold eight precepts either for 1 year or for 3 months, practicing and studying them.
就是以上那些四众弟子，还有净信的善男子、善女人呢，他们呢，对佛法因为有清净的信心。就是很认真的要持戒修行了啊，那进一步受持八分斋戒，也就是八关斋戒。那他持八关斋戒呢，他已经认真到什么程度呢？并不是一个月六斋日修六天罢了，他可以呢，经过一年时间，天天都持八关斋戒，或者是这个一年有三个重要的月叫做年三长斋月，那三个月就是正月五月跟九月，就是农历的正月五月九月，这三个月叫年三长斋月，或者他在这个三个月时间里面去受持这个八关斋戒，按照里面八关斋戒的教法去持戒修行，叫做受持学处，他所懂的有关八关斋戒的戒律的要求，身心清净其心的要求的，就是念佛、念法、念僧跟持八关斋戒，这样清净的来受持持戒修行，他能够做这样子的修行，已经能够这样子了之后的人，怎么样呢？我们等一下继续看。
So these are the fourfold assembly, along with pure good men, and good women with pure faith. So they have faith in the Buddha Dharma, and they're very serious in upholding the precepts. So how serious are they? They are so serious in upholding the eight precepts to a point they don't just uphold the eight precepts in 6 days per month. They uphold the eight precepts every day of the year, or there are three long vegetarian months. These are January, May, and September. So in these 3 months, they have taken the 8 vegetarian precepts. They are practicing and cultivating these precepts according to the Dharma. So we say practicing and studying them. In their body and mind, they are pure. They are mindful of the Buddha, Dharma, and the Sangha in upholding the precepts and cultivate. So this is what they do. So what's next? Let's see.
以此善根，愿生西方极乐世界无量寿佛所听闻正法而为定者。
With these gurus, they may vow to be born in the western land of ultimate bliss, where the Buddha of limitless life dwells, to hear the proper Dharma, but their resolve may not be firm.
就是说，以上呢，能够持八关斋戒，经过一年或者三月的修持的这些修行人呢，他们愿意呢，用持戒的功德善根呢，回向发愿，求生西方极乐世界，然后去极乐世界什么地方呢？就是阿弥陀佛的世界，哈，叫无量寿佛所，就是愿意去亲近阿弥陀佛，听闻正法，因为阿弥陀佛呢，现在呢。 成佛已经时节，但是佛的寿命无量无边，阿僧祇劫那么长远，所以呢，现在极乐世界还在正法当中，然后呢，他就愿意呢，这个众生呢，这个修行人呢，他想到自己呢已经离开释迦牟尼佛那么久了嘛，已经进入相法乃至末法了嘛，那像这样子的修行人呢，他很想要去亲近。 还在正法教化众生的佛，所以他愿意去极乐世界听闻正法。虽然这样子，而未定者，就是说他心是想去极乐世界，但他的心愿呐不够稳定，境界来的时候呢，他会改变主意，或者他心生怀疑，自己去不了极乐世界。 觉得自己功夫不够啊，种种的未定，没有那个定心啊，信心不足，或者是起怀疑心。So
these are the cultivators upholding the eight precepts for 1 year or for 3 months, and then they uphold the precepts, they make transference of their merit and virtue, make vows to seek rebirth in the land of ultimate bliss, to want to draw near to the Buddha of limitless life. So these are the cultivators who want to draw near to the Buddha who are still teaching living beings in the proper Dharma time. However, they in their resolve, in their mind, they really want to be reborn in a land of ultimate bliss. However, their resolve is not firm enough yet. When states come, they will still be influenced and turned by the states, or they have doubts about themselves that they probably cannot be reborn in the pure land, or they think that they don't have sufficient or mature skills to be reborn there. So these are the people who don't have enough faith or have doubts about themselves.
像这样子的人呢，如果他有这个善因缘，能够怎么样呢？我们继续看。若闻世尊药师琉璃光如来名号，临命终时有八大菩萨，其名曰。
So people like this, if they have good causes and conditions, what will happen? Let's continue to read on. However, if they hear the name of the World Honor One, Medicine Master Vaiduya Lai Tathagata, then as the end of their lives draw near, before them will appear 8 great bodhisattvas whose names are
就是说修净土法门修了很多年，然后也常常持八关斋戒，要回向求生西方，因为在16观经里面也是有提到的， 持八关斋戒去极乐世界，求生西方的人可以中品众生，或者中品看他修得怎么样啊，可以，反正就是中品众生都可以去往生极乐世界，一日一夜的八关斋。那所以他付出更多的努力，不只是一天哦，一年持八关斋或者三个月哦，这样子修持了一段日子之后，可能他还是信心不足啊，心不定。然后这样子的人，如果他有因缘遇到世尊药师琉璃光如来的名号，认识了这尊佛的名号功德，知道这尊佛他可以帮助我们满一切的心愿，他的十二本愿里面呢有提到有关他要护持众生满他的修行的愿嘛，那他知道呢，药师琉璃光如来名号呢是这么殊胜的话，那他听到了，他有这个因缘，也会懂得念南无消灾延寿药师佛也好，或者南无药师琉璃光如来也好，反正有机会一听到药师佛的名号之后、哦、然后他这个人呢他就有这个好的因缘了，临命终的时候呢他就会遇到有八大菩萨出现，他们的名字是谁呢？
Okay, so these are the cultivators who have been making vows to want to be reborn in a pure land for many years. They uphold the eight precepts, they make transference to be reborn in the West, like in the 16 Contemplation Sutra or 16 Visualization Sutra says that if one has upheld the eight vegetarian precepts and they make transference to be reborn in the pure land, they can be reborn in the middle grade of
middle level,
right? If they uphold the precepts for just one day and one night, eight precepts. Now, these people, the people we're talking about, they have applied a much more effort. They have upheld the precepts for 1 year or 3 months. So these are the people who don't have enough faith or their resolve is not firm enough. Now, if they have a chance to encounter the medicine master Vaiduya Lai Tathagata's name, know the Buddha's merit and virtue, and understand that this Buddha can help us fulfill our wishes, because this particular Buddha had made 12 vows to support and protect living beings to satisfy their wishes. So if these type of people know the vows of medicine master Buddha and know that the vows are so supreme, whether they could recite the lengthening life and eradicating disaster medicine master Buddha's name, or they recite medicine master Vaiduya Lai Tathagata's name, when they hear these names, when they have good causes and conditions, eight great bodhisattvas will appear in front of them. So who are these eight great bodhisattvas?
我也是等到这一次为了讲药师忏的这个妙义呢，才真正的去看到底是哪八大菩萨、哦、以前呢都没有真正的去了解。那我们现在来攻读一下哪八大菩萨会来接引我们去极乐世界的呢？请合掌。文殊师利菩萨、观世音菩萨、德大士菩萨、无尽意菩萨、宝昙花菩萨、药王菩萨、药上菩萨、弥勒菩萨。
As for me, because of this condition to explain the wonderful meanings of the medicine master repentance, I had a chance to take a look at these eight bodhisattvas. In the past, I did not truly understand or know who they are. So that's respectfully who these bodhisattvas are. These are Manjushri Bodhisattva, the bodhisattva who observe the sounds of the world. Back one. Great strength bodhisattva, inexhaustible intention bodhisattva, jewel Udambara flower bodhisattva, medicine king bodhisattva, medicine superior bodhisattva, and Maitreya bodhisattva.
那我们看啊，这八大菩萨呢会怎么样呢？是八大菩萨乘空而来，是其道路， 即于彼界种种杂色宝众宝花中自然化生。
So let's see what would these eight bodhisattvas do. Those eight great bodhisattvas will appear in space to show them the way, and they will naturally be reborn by transformation in that then, amid precious flower of a myriad colors.
好，就是修八关斋戒求生西方的人心呢还不稳定，但是能够有机会遇到药师佛，闻到佛名之后呢，临命中，因为佛就会加持你嘛，让你呢信心稳定下来，然后你将来还会有八大菩萨，就是刚才所说的那八位菩萨呢乘空而来哦，好，他们呢在你临终的时候就出现了，就来找你了，是其道路，就是会引导你通往西方的道路，他们会带着你呢去极乐世界，然后你就会在极乐世界的什么地方出世呢？就是种种杂色众宝花，极乐世界七宝莲池里面呢的莲花呢，不是普通的花，是金银琉璃玻璃车骑赤珠玛瑙各种的宝的花，而且不同颜色，是看个人因地修行的功德不一样，你将来的莲花颜色也不一样。你的莲花是哪一种宝也不同，是看个人的因地修行。反正呢，你到了那边呢，你就会自然呢，从这个众杂色众宝花中自然而然的化生出来，哈，是化生的。
Okay, so these are the good men and good women who have cultivated the eight precepts.However, their mind is not stable and firm. Now they have the opportunity to hear the name of Medicine Master Buddha. So this Buddha will bless this person for them to have firm and stable resolve. So in the future, there are eight great bodhisattvas who will appear in space. At the moment of our death, they will show you the way to the Pure Land.So where would one be reborn in the Pure Land? They will be reborn by transformation in that land amid a precious flowers of myriad colors. These aren't just ordinary flowers. These are flowers made with gold, silver, lapis lazuli, crystal, carnelians, red pearls, and so on. So depending on your cultivation, your skills in the causal ground, you will be reborn in these flowers, depending on your skills.
We'll look at the first one, Namo Wen Shu Shi Li Pusa.
We will see the first Bodhisattva, Namo Manjushri Bodhisattva.
These eight Bodhisattvas are本身呢都是护持十方诸佛的啦，包括呢阿弥陀佛还有药师佛都是他们在护持的，所以药师佛要满众生的愿，然后这些菩萨们呢也会呢一起来护持药师佛的愿力，让呢药师佛他想要帮助那些要去极乐世界的人哈。他就是要满那些众生的愿，然后药师佛没有来带我们去，但是呢这八个菩萨就知道该做事了嘛，他们是护持佛的嘛，佛想要让这个人顺利去极乐世界，然后这八尊佛就会帮他做事了，就出面来带我们走，带我们去极乐世界。好，那这很重要的哦，八大菩萨第一位就是文殊师利菩萨，大智慧者文殊菩萨，也是华严海会的佛菩萨的上首菩萨，就是文大智慧，他是诸佛的老师，过去现在诸佛都是文殊菩萨教化八阿耨多罗三藐三菩提而成就的。如果你拜万佛宝忏你就知道了，万佛宝忏第十卷特别有讲到文殊菩萨是过去现在诸佛他都是他们的老师，所以呢要这位这么伟大的菩萨呢来带我们去极乐世界啊，我们真的是有心要去极乐世界的人呢就能够获得两位佛来护持我们，就是阿弥陀佛的四十八大愿愿意带我们去 然后让摄受我们去极乐世界，然后我们在这里有障碍，有一尊佛特别除障碍的佛，就是药师佛，他就发心来让那些想去极乐的人无障碍，所以呢，他也就派了这八大菩萨来成就我们的心愿啊。所以你们要看啊，我们为了要去极乐世界哦，不要卡在娑婆里面轮回呢，都需要八大菩萨、阿弥陀佛跟那个药师佛他们一起来帮助我们呐、啊，不然我们在这里轮回无量劫了，想要出离这个三界轮回可不简单了。那所以，为了要出离这个生死呢，真的都是要靠佛菩萨的救度的。所以我们对佛菩萨都要有一种呢感恩的心，也要学习他们的大慈大悲的心来。平等心来普度一切众生。
Okay, so this is Manjushri Great Bodhisattva. The eight Great Bodhisattvas actually they protect and support all the Buddhas in the ten directions, including Amitabha Buddha and Medicine Master Buddha. So Medicine Master Buddha's vows.Are to fulfill living beings' wishes. So these bodhisattvas will support and actually protect Medicine Master Buddha's vows. So since Medicine Master Buddha wished to fulfill living beings' wish, then these eight bodhisattvas will be put into work, or they will start working for us to help us. So Medicine Master Buddha want to fulfill living beings' wish.So this bodhisattva will then help Medicine Master Buddha. They will come to guide us to the Pure Land. So Manjushri Bodhisattvas have the foremost and the great wisdom. He's also the leader of Avatamsaka or Huayan Assembly Buddhas and Bodhisattvas. He is the teachers of all Buddhas from the past and the present. So,Buddhas in the past and present are taught by Manjushri Bodhisattva. He made vows to come and teach all the Buddhas. So in the 10,000 Buddhas repentance, it also mentioned that Manjushri Bodhisattva had made vows to teach Buddhas of the past and present. So now we have this really great Bodhisattvas to come and take us to the Pure Land. Now, in order to be reborn in the Pure Land,There are two Buddhas who support us in doing so. There is the Amitabha Buddha and Medicine Master Buddha. Amitabha Buddha had made 48 vows to gather us in and take us to the Pure Land. And then there's another Buddha, Medicine Master Buddha, who specialized in helping us eliminating our obstacles so we can be reborn in the Pure Land without any obstructions. So these two Buddhas will send a great Bodhisattvas.To help us accomplish our vows, our wishes. Now, these eight great bodhisattvas will support Amitabha Buddha and Medicine Master Buddha. They come to help us. We have been transmigrating in the Saha world for limitless eons. It is really not easy to transcend the three realms in order to leave behind birth and death.These two Buddhas will come to help us. So we are most grateful for their great compassion and great kindness that they will universally rescue all living beings with equanimity, with an equal mind.
所以我们也要跟他们学习，要有这种大慈悲心跟平等心。
So we willAlso want to learn from them to have this great kindness and great compassionate mind and this great mind of equanimity.
第二尊南无观世音菩萨。
This is南无观世音Bodhisattva who observes the sounds of the world.
那大家都知道啦，观音菩萨就是极乐世界的上首菩萨嘛。以后阿弥陀佛入涅槃之后呢，就是轮到观音菩萨成佛了。所以观音菩萨也是属于八大菩萨的其中第二位。
Okay, so everyone knows about Guanyin Bodhisattva. She She is a leader of the land of ultimate bliss. So when Amitabha Buddha enters Nirvana, Guanyin Bodhisattva will become a Buddha right away. So he is the second in the eight Bodhisattvas.
文殊菩萨也是他方世界将来会成佛的一位菩萨，他其实同时也是其他世界的佛来。好，然后观音菩萨呢，也是即将成佛的，他是这个是第二尊啊。第三尊是南无大势至菩萨。
Okay, so Manjushri Great Bodhisattva will eventually realize Buddhahood in other worlds. At the same time, he's also a Buddha in other worlds too. Guanyin Bodhisattva will soon become a Buddha. The third Bodhisattva is Namo Great Strength Bodhisattva.
那大势至菩萨是极乐世界的观音菩萨入涅槃之后的接下来的佛，就是大势至菩萨就会继承那个佛位。
So in the land of ultimate bliss, after Guanyin Bodhisattva enters Nirvana, a great strength Bodhisattva will inherit the throne of a Buddha.
换句话说呢，极乐世界目前的阿弥陀佛，他以后入了涅槃之后，就轮到观世音菩萨成佛，然后再来就是大势至菩萨，也就是说极乐世界的现在跟未来的总共三尊佛。 都在等着我们，愿意带领我们去极乐世界，他们会教化我们，一步一步，一直到成佛啊。Now,
so in other words, in the land of ultimate bliss, Amitabha Buddha, Guanyin Bodhisattva, and Great Strength Bodhisattva are the three Buddhas of the present and the future time. All of them are waiting for us to take us to the land of ultimate bliss for us to realize Buddhahood there.
第四尊南无无尽意菩萨.
The fourth Bodhisattva is Namo Inexhaustible Intention Bodhisattva.
那么无尽意菩萨的一些功德跟修行呢，你们可以参考。 宣光上人在《法华经》讲解这个观世音菩萨普门品第25的时候，他有提到无尽意菩萨，有关无尽意菩萨的一些道理，很重要的，你们自己去参考。Okay,
so the merit and virtue, and the cultivation of, inexhaustible intention Bodhisattva. You can actually reference the commentary of the Lotus Sutra explained by Venerable Master Hua. He explained this Bodhisattva's merit, virtue, and cultivation in chapter 25, which is the Universal Door chapter of the Lotus Sutra. It was explained there. So you can reference the principles there.
都知道说这个无尽意菩萨就问问题嘛，所以他也是属于好像是普门品的当机众这样子，所以也是他请法的，所以他跟我们也是蛮熟悉的啦。只要有念过普门品的人都知道有一尊无尽意菩萨嘛，所以他也会带我们去极乐世界。
So when we bow the Universal Door Chapter, we all know about Namo Inexhaustible Intention Bodhisattva. He is the one who asks questions. He is the interlocutor of this particular chapter. He's also the one who requested the Dharma. So we're all very familiar with this Bodhisattva's name. If you have bowed or heard the Universal Door chapter, you will know about this Bodhisattva.
他就是把他的璎珞扯断的拿来供养。 想要供养观世音菩萨，是观世音菩萨不肯受之，然后佛说您应该受接受无尽意菩萨的供养啊，就是这尊啊。Okay,
so this particular Bodhisattva at the end took off his necklace, his jewel necklace, to make offerings to Guanyin Bodhisattva, but Guanyin Bodhisattva did not want to accept the offering just yet. So the Buddha had exhorted Guanyin Bodhisattva, advised her to take this offering, and then Guanyin Bodhisattva took this offering. This is the Bodhisattva that we're talking about here.
我们现在看第五尊南无宝昙花菩萨。
The fifth Bodhisattva that we're looking at, Namo Jewel Udambara Flower Bodhisattva.
宝昙花菩萨，你看他的手是拿着优昙菠萝花啊。就这尊佛，这尊菩萨呢，也是难招难遇的，好像优昙菠萝花一样呢，千年才开花一次哦，就是不容易遇到的一尊菩萨。他也会属于护持这个药师佛跟阿弥陀佛的菩萨。
So this is Udambara flower bodhisattva. You see that on her hand she is holding Udambara flower. This is also a flower that is hard to encounter, or this bodhisattva is hard to encounter. Just like the Udambara flower, it blossoms once in 1,000 years, which is not easy to encounter. He also supports and protects Medicine Master Buddha and Amitabha Buddha.
第六尊南无药王菩萨。
The sixth bodhisattva, Namo Medicine King Bodhisattva.
然后第七尊南无药上菩萨。
Seventh one, Namo Medicine Superior Bodhisattva.
药王跟药上两位菩萨在法华经里面呢，就有药王药上菩萨本事品嘛，所以你们要认识他们呢，去看这一品你就知道了。
So this is a Medicine King Bodhisattva and Medicine Superior Bodhisattva.Both of them are described in the Lotus Sutra. So if you want to know about these two bodhisattvas, you should read the Lotus Sutra.
最后第八尊南无弥勒菩萨。
Now the last one, the eighth one, Namo Maitreya Bodhisattva.
那大家都知道了，弥勒菩萨是我们娑婆世界的未来佛。他是贤劫的第五尊佛。
Okay, so all of us know Manjushri Bodhisattva. He is the future Buddha to be. He's the fifth Bodhisattva in the worthy Kalpa.
所以你看八大菩萨里面呢，有两尊是极乐世界的未来佛，一尊是娑婆世界的未来佛。你看即将成佛的菩萨们呢，都是一心一意呢，要帮助众生呢，很快成佛。所以他们将来成了佛，也都会继续教化我们这些众生的。那所以他们也这么积极的哈，要成就所有想要成佛、要去极乐世界成佛的人，他会帮忙带领你们去。然后从这里我们就可以知道了，其实呢，不是临终他们才出现的。如果你们这次能够学习药师忏的妙义，同时每个月能够呢花一天时间跟着我们金山圣士，每个月拜一次药师忏呢，其实能够这么做的话呢，我相信大家临命终时呢，八大菩萨一定来带你们去极乐世界的。不止如此，不是临终他们才出现了，而是平时在生活当中，我相信八大菩萨也会默默中在护持着我们，让我们罪孽福增慧长，让我们呢能够真正的越来越有信愿求生西方的心，信愿恨三资粮都能够越修越进步，莲花越来越大，他们一定会默默中这样子护持我们的。
Okay, so these are, among these eight bodhisattvas, there are two bodhisattvas who are the future Buddha in the land of ultimate bliss. One of them is a future Buddha in the Saha world, and they single-mindedly really want to help living beings to quickly realize Buddhahood. So they will, after these bodhisattvas realize Buddhahood, they will come to continue to teach living beings.And they really so seriously want to help us to be reborn in the Pure Land. They don't just appear in front of us at the end of our lives. But I believe that if we can study the wonderful meanings of Medicine Master Repentance and bow Medicine Master Repentance once a month with us, I believe that these eight great bodhisattvas will definitely appear before the end of your life to guide you to the Pure Land. They don't just appear before the end of your life or at the moment of your death. I'm sure that they will quietly protect and support you to help us eradicate our karmic offenses, to increase our blessings, to open up our wisdom, to increase our wisdom, so that our faith and vows can increase, and then we're replete with the three provisions to be reborn in the land of ultimate bliss. So they will definitely help protect us quietly.
我们现在呢，一起来赞叹这八尊菩萨，用诚心呢，我们唱念呢，他们的圣号，一起来唱念呢，用那个弘一大师以前他还没出家前所做的那个调，就是送别的调，来希望呢，八大菩萨到时送我们去极乐世界，我们一起来唱。
So now let's together praise these eight great bodhisattvas. We are going to use the tune that was composed by Master Hong Yi before he left the home life. So the tune is called Farewell. So now let's sincerely chant and praise these eight great bodhisattvas.
希望他们送我们去极乐世界嘛，送别。
Okay, so because we want them to send us to the land of ultimate bliss, so we use the tune Farewell.
Namo Vasu Shili Pusa. Namo Vasu Shili Pusa. Namo Guanshiyin Bosa. Namo Guanshiyin Bosa. Namo Namo 天天的护持我们，令我们具足。 大智慧如文殊菩萨，大悲如观音菩萨，然后呢有大势菩萨的那种念佛三昧的力量，然后有无尽意菩萨的他们那种无量的慈悲心，还有宝昙花菩萨、药王菩萨、药上菩萨。也许我们对这些其他菩萨呢不是很认识，但是他们都有无量的菩萨和无量的福慧跟功德，他们都会满众生的种种愿，也会让我们身体健康。药王药上菩萨特别是会帮助我们身体健康的啦。那弥勒菩萨会让我们有大的那个忍辱力跟大慈力，有大的慈心，还有忍耐的力量，就是遇到任何境界呢，心都能够忍可于心，不动于心，要有那种定力。
Okay, so we really hope that the eight great bodhisattvas will not forget us disciples. So So every day they will help protect and support us. We wish that we will have the great wisdom like Manjushri Bodhisattva, the great compassion of Guanyin Bodhisattva, and the samadhi of Buddha recitation of great strength Bodhisattva. The great kindness, great compassion of inexhaustible intention Bodhisattva. As for the Udambara Flower Bodhisattva, Medicine King Bodhisattva, and Medicine Superior Bodhisattva, although we are not too familiar with them, but we know that these great bodhisattvas have bodhisattvas' practices, their merit and virtue. They will fulfill living beings' wishes. So, Medicine King Bodhisattva, Medicine Superior Bodhisattva will help living beings have a healthy physical body. Maitreya Bodhisattva have great compassion, great kindness. They have, he has the strength of being extremely patient. So in any state that we encounter, that our mind is always patient, stably. So we will have this kind of samadhi power in our mind.
好，我们现在可以看呢，另外一本书叫做《佛说阿弥陀经》译书，是西湖灵芝崇福寺释圆照述，就是圆照大师所述的一本讲解有关阿弥陀经这一本经的义理的一个书抄，这是圆照大师所写的，我们看一看。
Okay, so now we would like to reference another text. It's called the Commentary on the Meaning of the Buddha Speaks of Amitabha Sutra. It is written or composed by the Xi Yuan Zhao of Chongfu Monastery at Xihu Lingzhi. So this is a commentary written by this great Dhamma master explaining the meaning of Amitabha Sutra.
Okay. 药师经云，若彼佛名入其耳中，堕恶道者无有是处。
The Medicine Master Sutra says, if that Buddha's name enters a person's ears, it would be impossible for that person to fall into the evil path.
圆照大师他在讲阿弥陀经的时候，他也是提到药师经，所以你看古来的高僧大德呢，他们深入经藏，智慧如海，是有那个全面的理解，就是可以算是那种大开圆解的智慧，不会像我们呢有些人呢对佛法呢就有一点点偏，比如说我接受阿弥陀佛我就不能接受药师佛，就不会有这种的偏见。你就要知道说呢，每一尊佛都是要来帮助我们的，我们执着一尊佛其实也是不行的，因为在华严经里面有讲到任何一位菩萨都不可以执着任何一尊佛或者任何一个佛国度，他一定要呢他的心量要大如整个法界，因为我们的自信呢是没有一个限量的，所以我们的心量也是一样，对好与不好的境界都要一律平等心去看待，然后对所有十方诸佛跟菩萨都是一样恭敬归命顶礼，都是 理一佛就是理一切佛，理一切佛其实也是理一佛，对这种义理一定要明白。所以呢，玄奘大师在讲解阿弥陀经，他也特别提到药师经，他说药师经里面讲，假如有人呢有机会呢听到彼佛药师佛的名号啊，他的名号一进入你的耳朵，你听到了，你这个人还会堕恶道的话呢，绝对是不可能的事情，是无有是处的。
Okay, so this is the commentary of Amitabha Sutra by Great Master Yuan Zhao. He also mentioned Medicine Master Sutra in his commentary. As here you can see, in the ancient virtuous one, when they enter the sutra treasury, they really have the wisdom like the sea. They have great perfect understanding and wisdom, so they were not one-sidedly attached to just one Buddha, for example, Amitabha Buddha. Or Medicine Master Sutra, actually a Medicine Master Buddha. Every Buddha comes to help us. We should not be attached to just one Buddha only. We can't attach to any Bodhisattva either. In the Avatamsaka Sutra, it says that we can't be attached to just one Buddha or one Buddha land. Our mind should be as vast as the Dharma realm because our inherent nature is boundless and limitless. So our mind should be the same. Whether it's good, a favorable state or not favorable state, we should regard it with a mind of equanimity. So Buddha, for Buddhas of all the Buddhas and Bodhisattvas in the 10 direction, we should respectfully, reverently take refuge within them and bow to them, pay respect to them. When we bow to one Buddha, it's the same as bowing to all the Buddhas. When bowing to all the Buddhas, it's the same as bowing to one Buddha. So we must understand this principle and this meaning. So in commentary written by Great Master Yuan Zhao, he said that if the Buddha's name enters a person's ear, it would be impossible for that person to fall into the evil path.
阿难，诸佛境界成为难信，皆是如来威力，非声闻之佛所能信受，唯除补处菩萨耳。
Ananda, all Buddha states are truly difficult to believe except through the awe-inspiring powers of the Tathagata, and that they are not something that hearers and Pratyeka Buddhas are able to believe and accept. The exceptions are Bodhisattvas who are destined in one life to attain Buddhahood.
好，圆照大师他又继续讲药师经所说的这一段文，他说《药师经》里面继续还告诉阿难，有一段是说，阿难啊，诸佛的境界呢，真的是很难令人相信的。如果你能够信啊，都也就是因为有如来的威神力加持你的，像你能够相信我讲《药师经》，是因为我加持你的关系啊。所有的声闻啊、辟支佛啊，他们是很难信受诸佛的境界的，除非你是一生不处的菩萨。
Okay, so in the commentary, my great master Yuan Zhao, he continues to say, the Medicine Master Sutra says that the Buddha's states are hard to fathom and to believe or encounter. If you can actually believe, it's also because the blessings from the Tathagata. For example, like you're listening to the Medicine Master Sutra now, the fact that you can actually believe it, it comes from the blessing of the Buddha. The hearers and the Pratyeka Buddhas cannot accept or believe it, with the exceptions that Bodhisattvas are destined in one life to attain Buddhahood.
那我们呢看看一下，就是刚才是圆照大师的注解，现在看真正的经文提到有关这种道理的部分。现在给大家看的是这第二本药师经，另外一个版本的药师经叫做佛说药师如来本愿经，它是随天竺三藏达摩吉多译他所翻译的。
Okay, so we were just looking at the commentary by Great Master Yuan Zhao. Now I'm going to show you the second translation version of the Medicine Master Sutra. So it's called, the title is called the Sutra of the Meridian Virtue of the Past Vows of Medicine Master Vaiduya Lai Tathagata. It's translated during the Sui Dynasty by Tripitaka Master Dhammagupta from India.
好。佛言阿难作比如来所有名号入其耳中此人堕恶道者无有是处。
The Buddha said, Ananda, if all the names of that Buddha enters a person's ears, it will be impossible for that person to fall into the evil path.
这一个版本的药师经呢里面提到佛言就是释迦牟尼佛说对谁说对阿难他说阿难啊若比如来所有名号啊，若比如来呢，就是指的那个药师佛哦，他的所有的名号，每一尊佛都有很多种名号嘛，尤其是药师佛，我们最熟悉就是刚才讲的那两种，他的所有名号呢，能够进入你的耳朵，给你听到了。像今天你一开始也听到了南无药师琉璃光如来，南无消灾延寿药师佛，你一听到我念这两个名号啊。一进入你耳朵，恭喜你了。你如果将来会堕恶道的话呢，这绝对是不可能的。这是释迦佛亲口说的，那个我们会得到的果报，就是绝对不堕三恶道。
Okay, so this is a Medicine Master Sutra. So the Buddha said to Ananda, what did he say?He said that if Medicine Master Buddha, if you hear this Buddha's name, the name of that Buddha refers to Medicine Master Buddha. Of course, a Buddha could have many, many names. And for this Buddha, we were familiar with his two names like we have heard before. It is Medicine Master Vaiduya Lai Tathagata or Lengthening Life, Quelling Disaster, Medicine Master Buddha. When you hear any of this Buddha's names enter one person's ear, if one falls into the evil path, that is impossible. It's impossible for them to fall into the evil path. So this is what Shakyamuni Buddha has said to us.
阿难，诸佛境界成为男性，汝今性受，应知皆是如来威力。
Ananda, all Buddha's states are truly difficult to believe. You should know that your ability to believe and accept these comes from the awe-inspiring powers of the Tathagata.
这个经文就是说的啦，他说阿难啊，诸佛的境界啊，都是很难令众生相信的。今天你能够信，又能够接受啊，你应该知道啊，都是如来我的威神的力量帮助你的。
Okay, so Buddha continued to say to Ananda, the Buddha stage are really hard to believe. And the fact that you are able to believe and accept this really comes from the awe-inspiring powers of the Buddha.
所以你们现在听我讲到这里呢, so far 所听到的呢, 你都能接受, 都能相信呢, 我告诉你, 这也是释迦牟尼佛还有药师佛他们的威力加持你，你才可以去相信跟接受的。
So now you're listening to the lecture up to this point. If you are able to accept and believe what has been said so far about Medicine Master Buddha and this repentance, it all comes from the awe-inspiring powers of the Tathagata.
非一切声闻必知佛地所能信受唯除一生补处菩萨摩诃萨
There are not something that all hearers and Pratyeka Buddhas are able to believe and accept. The exceptions are Bodhisattvas who are destined in one life to attain Buddhahood.
所以有关诸佛的不可思议的境界呢是真的只有一生补处即将成佛的等觉菩萨们他们才能够完全没有怀疑，能够相信，能够接受。那一般的小乘的声闻跟辟支佛呢，出果、二果、三果、四果、阿罗汉呢，还有辟支佛，他们都没办法信受，除非有佛加持他们，他们才能够信得了。
Okay, so Buddha's inconceivable states are hard to fathom. These, with the exceptions of bodhisattvas who are destined in one life to attain Buddhahood. So even those of the lesser vehicle, Pratyeka Buddhas, people of the first fruition, second fruition, third and fourth fruition, cannot accept or believe. If they can, they are able to accept and believe, it's because of Buddha's support and Buddha's blessings.
阿难, 人生难得, 于三宝中, 信敬尊重, 义难可得, 文笔如来名号, 悖难于此。
Ananda, it is difficult to obtain a human body. It is also difficult to have faith in and to revere the three jewels. It is even more difficult to be able to hear the name of that Tathagata.
佛又告诉阿难啊，他说啊，人生啊，要得到这个人的身体呢，真的不容易的。这个在其他经典都有讲了，相信大家都懂。然后呢，很多人，全世界，有70多亿人口，这么多人都得到了人生，但是到底有多少人能够对三宝有信心，又能够恭敬尊重呢？ 能够这么做的人啊，那正是人中的宝咯。他是这种的能力呢，更难能可贵，比得人生更难。然后又能够再进一步呢，不但对佛法、对三宝呢有信心，能够恭敬尊重，又能够呢听闻有关药师佛他的名号的功德。 能够有机会去了解他的名号功德啊，那种人啊，他是属于呢，更难得了，倍难于此啊，比那个尊重、相信、恭敬三宝哈，还更难能可贵一倍，哦，不止一倍，很多倍。So
the Buddha told Ananda, it is really difficult to obtain a human form, a human body. Now, I believe that other sutras have talked about this, how hard it is. I believe everyone understands this principle. Now, in the entire world, there are 7 billions of people. And out of these people, how many of them have faith in the three jewels? How many of them can respectfully revere the three jewels? If one can do that, they are actually the jewel among people. So it is even harder, not only they have faith in the three jewels, respect and revere the three jewels, they can believe in the Buddha Dharma and understand the Buddha's merit and virtue. These people are even harder. Now to hear the name of this Buddha is even more difficult. How difficult? Maybe twice, maybe even much more difficult than that.
好，所以呢，我们每个人呢要知道哦，在这里讲说闻彼如来名号哦，其实不是只是说听大家都认识嘛，药师佛，药师佛。但是呢，闻名号不是只是闻到他的名字这么简单呢，应该是包括认识这尊佛的功德吧。Okay,
so when we hear Medicine Master Buddha's name, we all heard his name before, but I believe that it's not just listening to his name. This should also include understanding, knowing the merit and virtue of this Buddha.
那我们看为什么呢，能够闻彼如来名号的人呢，是属于彼。 只能够对三宝尊重、相信的人更难能可贵呢？因为这种人是福报特别大，他才有机会，他有很大的福报跟善根，才有机会能够进一步去认识彼如来的名号的。然后为什么他如果能够这么做就很难能可贵呢？因为要能够有机会认识这尊佛啊。 这尊佛为什么闻了他的名号你就很好很好呢？因为他的功德非常大。我们看一下，阿难，彼世尊药师琉璃光如来，无量菩萨恨，无量诸巧辩，无量旷大愿。
Okay, so why is that it is harder for people to believe, to listen or hear the names of the Buddha than those who have been respectful and revere the three jewels. It's because this Buddha has great merit and great virtue, so that we can understand this Buddha. So why is it so good to understand or hear the great merit and virtue of this Buddha? It's because this particular Buddha's merit and virtue is really immense. So the sutra says, Ananda, the world under one, medicine master Vaidya Lai Tathagata, possesses boundless bodhisattva practices, limitless skillful means, and immeasurable vast great vows.
为什么闻佛名号是最难能可贵的呢？ 因为佛说阿难啊，比世尊药师琉璃光如来啊， 他为什么会成就这么好的功德的名号呢？ 就因为他无量劫以来啊， 他修了无量无边的菩萨恨， 还有无量无边的善巧方便要度化众生， 发了无量无边的大愿。 这些愿 他修成就了，他的恨愿成功了，他才能够有这么殊胜的名号功德。
Okay, so why is it so hard to listen or hear the Buddha's name? Why is it so rare? It's why medicine master Vaidya Lai Tathagata is so hard to hear. It's actually this Buddha has boundless bodhisattva practices. He is made, he has limitless skillful means and have great vast vows. So when his practices and vows are fulfilled and accomplished, and this bodhisattva's merit and virtue becomes very special.
我欲一劫若过一劫，说彼如来菩萨恨愿乃至穷劫，彼世尊药师琉璃光如来本习所行及殊胜大愿，亦不究竟。If
I were to speak of that Tathagata's Bodhisattva practices and vows for an eon or more, the eon would soon end. But that world honor one, medicine master Vaidya Lai Tathagata's past practices and supreme great vows have no end.
所以释迦牟尼佛呢，他就用一个譬喻来讲了，说他的那个以前所行的种种恨，还有所发的种种殊胜大愿呢，真的是太广大。 广大到什么程度呢？我如果用一劫的时间来讲说，或者超过一劫，然后讲了这么久的时间来谈论有关如来的以前的菩萨恨愿，然后谈论到多久呢？乃至于近未来劫啊，没有停止的一直在讲解，也没有办法讲完他的殊胜大愿跟他所修的那个大恨。 他的大恨大愿呢，是没有办法用无量劫来说，无量劫穷劫来讲都讲不完，所以你们可以知道吗？我们的生命那么短暂，我们怎么有办法去认识真正药师佛过去所修的种种大恨大愿呢？是不可能知道的。但是就是因为他有这么不可思议的大恨大愿，才能够成就他的功德名号，让人家闻到他的佛名呢，就可以呢消灾免难啊，除罪啊，除障啊，让你就满一切的菩萨恨啊，让你能够圆满成佛。这个他有这个力量给我们，是因为他有那种永远讲不完的那种大恨大愿的修行啊。
So Shakyamuni Buddha used an analogy to explain this concept to us. He said that this Bodhisattva had cultivated great practice, had made great special supreme vows. His vows are, his practice and vows are so vast that if we were to use one eon to explain them, it could not be exhausted. And so with this such long time to explain or discuss the Bodhisattva's practices and vows, he could not finish telling us. So even to the end of time, he could not finish telling us the great practice and vows made by Medicine Master Buddha. So, so we cannot finish, or the Buddha cannot finish talking about this particular Buddha's limitless, boundless, great vows, even until the end of time. Now, our human life is so short. How are we able to truly understand and know the great vows and great practice cultivated by Medicine Master Buddha? So because of the inconceivable great practices and great vows that Medicine Master Buddha had cultivated, as soon as once we hear his name, where he is able to help us eradicate our disasters, to be free of calamities, to eliminate our karmic obstacles, it's all because of his past practices and vows. That's why he has this power and strength to bestow on us. So his great practice and great vows are just inexhaustible. We can't finish talking about them, or the Buddha cannot finish talking about them.
对, 说, 佛说我自己的讲不完, 亦不究竟, 不要说到我们啊, 哦。
So the Buddha said, even I cannot exhaust, I cannot finish talking about the great practice and great vows of the Medicine Master Buddha, let alone us.
好，那现在时间差不多了，先预告一下下一次，也就是这个药师忏妙义第三讲的时间呢、啊，是下个月的太平洋时间是22号，然后马来西亚时间23号，然后我改成说3点半就可以开始请法了，这边的时间是3点半，马来西亚时间是6点半早上。就可以开始请法，所以你们大概就是提早5分钟，也就是早上6点25分可以进来，或者太平洋时间3点25分进来。
Okay, so time is about to run out. I'd like to give you a preview of our next lecture. It is going to be on Pacific time, May 22nd, 2021, Saturday. We are going to start at 3:30. We are going to start requesting the Dharma at 3:30. And Malaysian time is 6:30 in the morning. So you can come in about 5 minutes before that, 3:25 Pacific time.
You 们现在有看到这个回向了吗？看得到吗？
Not yet.
Not yet. Okay.So I have to re-share again. Okay. 大家看到回向了哈?
Not really.
啊,你没看到? Okay, 没看到,那我现在有看到吗?还是没有哈?
可能要 reshare 是不是
reshare? I have to reshare. Reshare. Can you see?
Yes.
Okay, 我们现在回向。愿以此功德庄严佛净土，上报四重恩，下济三途苦。若有见闻者，悉发菩提心，尽此一报身，同生极乐国。顶礼老和尚。我们下次再见，阿弥陀佛。
阿弥陀佛 ，Thank you, Yang 法师 ，Thank you, everyone.